Welcome to Analytics with Nags. We have reached end of the year, that is December 2021, and I hope this will be a last catch-up video for this year. In this video, I'm going to discuss about Power BI Italy's December 2021 version. Without further delay, let's jump into our today's topic. I'm into Power BI website, where the Power BI December 2021 features are listed here. I have very important or the most important concept that I thought it will never be possible, which has happened in Power BI. I will come to that point later point of this video. Let's begin with the reporting section, where Sparklines. This is a predominant or basic functionality which exists in the SSRS and other BI tools as well. This is very delay in Power BI, but now it is part of it. What the Sparklines will do is, like, you have a table or matrix visual. In those visuals, you want to see a trend. Okay, so you see here, you add a numerical value that is called a measure. For that measure, you right click on it and you say add sparkline. Then you need to configure what sparkline you want to see as part of that table, and I hope there are some options to change the sparkline as a line chart, or you can also change it to bar charts, small bars or columns charts like this, so that you can able to analyze the trend or how it performed, economic cycles, or highlight maximum and minimum values. So this is the very good feature, and it has been asked for long, and now it's part of our December 2021 version. And next is, like, we have understand, like, in previous versions, the Power BI has come up with a new format pane, and there are some of the options are missing or which has to be included. They have included lot more options mentioned here, like action card for buttons, global text size for table and matrix. It's a global means, like, I think I never tried. What I pre-assume is, like, you click on a table and all columns should have same I mean to say, like, when you fix at the global level, all table and matrix follow the same size. How many tables and matrix visual you have used, I will talk about it in one of the videos. So these is two important reporting aspects of it, and next followed by data connectivity. As we aware, like, lot of connectors, mostly the common Power BI users won't use these things, but those who are using it, you can check. There is some connector updates that FHIR, Dreamio software, TIBCO, all those things. These are some of the concepts, like connectors. Day by day, Power BI is adding. Initially it started with 80 or 90, now it will be more than 120 source connections it can able to connect. Now coming to the most important factor I liked in this release, it's a preview feature. Now this feature is whatever I thought it's not possible, or it's which is very difficult to implement, correct? Now what this concept about hybrid tables, we all know either a table can be import mode or a direct query mode, and there is an option for incremental refresh for large data sets. These are some of the options, and based on our needs we will choose either one of them. And even if it is incremental refresh, it is part of the import mode only, correct? So you load the data and all the data is stored in Power BI. What is the concept of hybrid table? As we all aware, hybrid means combination of any two possible methods. So here you can see you hold your historical data in import mode, that is archived. Then you use incremental refresh for some period. Then for current day, today's date, you use the direct query. See, basically this hybrid table concept works with the incremental refresh, and you need to have a Power BI premium license, and which incorporates or includes two concepts, import and direct query mode, together in a single table. You see, import for archive table or previous data, and direct query for the current data. This is implemented in a perspective like, even we say like for huge data sets, we will go for incremental refresh. That will reduce the time when you refresh your data, because these data are not going to change. Then we said you go for incremental refresh. This is the option we till now we have used. But even after implementing incremental refresh, there are some delays in refreshing a data. Okay, because if the data set is too huge, so in those cases we will go for hybrid models, where hybrid tables, right? This is in the preview and you can start using it as part of this release when you enable that preview option. And this is along with the incremental refresh, and you should have a Power BI premium license. This is most interesting feature for me as part of this release. Then you can assign a workspace to a pipeline stages. This is another important concept. If you're not aware of what is pipeline, you have different environments like dev, UAT and production. You can maintain the same Power BI file in the different environments, right? Usually in software development lifecycle, we use different environments to manage it. So moving from one stage to another stage or on one environment, it's a nightmare. So using a deployment pipelines, you can do it in a single click. So in that concept, you can assign the workspaces now. Then improvements in the mobile apps, all other features are not generic or it's specific to a wide audience. I mean, it is not specific to wide audience, basically. So that's it about this release. The hybrid tables are going to game change this Power BI to next level. And I hope we will see in next year, January 2021 release, what are the new updates in Power BI. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.